Very simple. That's এখানে they will give the distance of vertical line. The question will be like this, number 2 and number 3. So this is the ordinates, this is the ordinates. So if we are here for the vertical ordinates, so vertical ordinates will be given, apply with some multiplier, then you will get the area function. After that, you again apply the ordinates, you will get the m function, again apply ordinates and you will get the I function. After this, you apply the Simpson rule, you will get the total area. Then you will get the first moment and the second moment. But remember, for the first moment, you have to apply summation of m function divided by 2. For second moment, you have to apply summation of function divided by 3. This is called the theorem. Then straightforward, we will find out the center of G below the tank top OZ. This is the figure. This is called the OZ tank top, and this is the water line. If it is given the height of water, so we will get the center of G below the tank top, first moment divided by area, will get. Then you apply head of water, in this case 2.2, will get the center of G below the water line. So before you got this below the tank top, then you added this, then you added this 2.2 head of water, then you will get the below the water line. After that, you will find out the center of pressure below the tank top by second moment divided by the first moment. Now we will get the load on the bulkhead will get by depth into density into area. Depth is total depth including the head of the water 8.34, this comes from here. The density is 1.025 and the area, that's we got initially 189.16. We will get the load on the bulkhead. Then by the theorem of parallax excess, ICG equal to IOZ minus area into depth of CG below the tank top. You say this is the ICG. We apply for the IOZ. IOZ is the second moment. IOZ is the second moment. Area is the first to determine the area. The depth of CG below the tank top, that is the below the tank top, that's mean below the OZ. The depth of CG, that's we had find it initially 6.14. So we had applied, we got the result. Then similarly, the I of water line equal to ICG, that's we got ICG into plus area into depth of CG below the water line. This time is below the water line. So below the water line, that's we had already find out the 8.34. We applied the all, we'll get the IW. Now center of pressure below the water line, as we got it from the below the water line, so center of pressure below the water line, IWL divided by area into depth of CG below the water line. So we will get total height, the center pressure below the water line. The head of water is 2.2. We deduct the center of pressure below the tank top, will get 7.86. If it is given the horizontal transverse, then remember full procedure is same, only the Simpson multiplier instead of this orient will apply the lever. You remember apply from the 0 0 1 2 3 4 5 6, like start from 0, not from the 1, start from the 0. Okay, and then first area will be as usual. For the first moment, you will multiply by additional h. So second moment you apply one more additional h. That's mean for the first moment is h, second moment is h square. For the vertical, it was divided by 2, m function divided by 2, and I function was divided by 3. So this is the basic difference in between these two types of question. Otherwise, the everything is same, like center of G below the tank top, first moment divided by the area, apply the head of water, center of G below the water line, and then get everything. All everything Mr. Prince, for listening. Thank you. This is all about the program first. This is